We're at the assembly area for the carnival later on this evening, and I have it with me Sean, who's well, I'll let him introduce himself. You are?
I'm the vice chairman of the Wessex Grand Prix Circuit, which does Dorset, Wiltshire and a bit of Somerset. We do from September to the end of October, just before we start this one.
So how many carnivals are there that you actually do?
Well, my club is not actually this year, we hope to be at next year, but we tend to usually do about 19 carnivals in the club itself.
That's quite a lot of carnivals.
It is, yes.
So how many people belong to one of these clubs on average?
Well, that can vary. I mean, so we're not out, we're down to 8. You need a minimum of 12, which is 6 on the cart and 6 on the ground. And basically, some of these clubs, they probably, some of them only have 12 members, some got 150, some got 200 members. So it's a lot of variation. That's the reason why you can see the difference in the carts, the build-up, the rest of it, and the technology. I mean, our cart probably cost between, well, it did cost about between 10 to 12,000. But a lot of these clubs, that can cost up to 60 to 70,000 pounds, if not more now. So it's a lot of difference.
Is that from scratch or from each year?
Each year. Because it's so much of the engineering. Because if you have, we was talking to some of the bigger clubs, like Gremlins, the rest of it, they said themselves, their carts are not designed to do the number of carnivals what we do, because they're in a very small area. Well, the main structure, there's not much to it. All right, it's well made, but it's not a main body, whereas ours, more main body. Obviously, you haven't got so much engineering stuff, and basically, we haven't got the money. We ain't got the money down our end. You know, up here in Bridgwater and all the rest of it's in their blood. You talk to most people in this area have been involved in it all the way through through the whole family. It's just gone down from one generation to another. So, yeah. Different kettle fish.
So these carts are judged?
Yes.
I believe every event?
Yeah, every carnival, yes. About between 60 to 80 judges en route, all the way through. Yeah, there's different sections. We've got like tableau, they stand still. You've got like feature, they do a routine. And then you do comic, which is what we usually do, and that's to make people laugh, do funny things. And then you've got juvenile, and then you get like the masqueraders, walkers and things like that. And they all get judged on movement, technology, lighting, music, movement, routine. They all get judged that and all the way through. They get like points out of 30 to 40 or something, it varies. So they all end up at the end. And then and obviously, you know, you come first, second, third, all the way down through. But yeah.
So these carts, they're not based on lorry trailers, obviously, like most floats are in carnivals.
A lot of these are either a tractor or a lorry unit. And obviously they've been changed into what they are now. And a lot of these are low loaders, like car transport loaders. So basically it gives you the bottom bit, and then you work on up it and build upon it. So it's all proper traders somewhere along the line, but they obviously cut it down to what they want and then use what they need to use on it.
So obviously everything's powered by a generator on the back.
Yeah.
Do the clubs own the generators or are they rented each time?
Obviously, of course, the vet that is, we've got our own. But a lot of these, I think a lot of these clubs now, even the bigger clubs, got their own. And some of them got like one in each unit, so you've got one in the tractor, one in the main bit. Because now you've got LED lights, you've got smaller generators, obviously it's cheaper to run, the rest of it, you're not using much fuel. A lot of difference these days, and they're a lot brighter. The only difference is you won't get no heat from them, whereas when it's cold, years ago you could put your hands over a light bulb or the halley lights just to get some heat. Doesn't work these days.
Yeah, I can remember the steam coming off of some of them in the past few years. So how many light bulbs are there on one of the big floats?
I wouldn't like to say how many thousands. There is thousands. Years ago, a lot of the clubs would have said about 20,000, 25,000. I mean, say, some of them, when the LED lights being so brighter, even some of the tableau ones, there's only about 200 or 300 light bulbs on there. There's how they're brighter and how they want to work it out on the lighting. But yeah, it does vary. Yeah, it does vary. I really couldn't say, but a lot of light bulbs.
So presumably all these LEDs are a much lower voltage now. Do you still have the problems you used to have if it's raining?
No. 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 You don't have broken light bulbs. You know, they don't go bang when the water pours on and the rest of it, the heat. Because obviously water and electric don't really mix. So basically you used to explode all of a sudden, so you get glass on your head and all that. But no, you don't get that problem now. Because there's not enough heat in the, well, mostly it's like plastic coating now on the top. You don't get that problem now. No, it's a lot safer that way. You don't get burnt on your light bulbs. Like I said, there's no heat from them now. So you've got advantages and disadvantages. But yeah.
Oh, well, thanks for an insight into it. Well, good luck this evening.
Right, thank you very much. Lovely, thank you. Thank
right, you. Here we are, and it's this evening now at the Glastonbury Carnival, and I've got Dan here, who, he's one of the Gremlins crew. So, what do you actually do on the crew?
Well, as little as possible, really. I'm part of the road crew, so we kind of get the car up together, make sure it's all working, all lit, and then when the caster on there, we help them out, make sure they're all happy, dancing away, doing what they're doing.
How many cast are there on this year?
I think we've got 36 or something like that around there.
Are you involved with the building of the carts through the year?
I do, yeah, I do. Some will say I don't, but I do tend to go down and do a bit. Not as much as some of the others who are pretty committed, but yeah, I do tend to do a little bit more this year than other years, so yeah.
So how long does it take to actually build one of these, you call them carts, don't you? They're not floats, are they?
No,
they're carts.
Definitely carts, so yeah, we'll start stripping the cart. Well, as soon as we finish tonight, we'll be taking lamps out straight away, and then we'll get it in the shed, and we'll literally start stripping it straight away. And then we'll start some meetings talking about next year's idea. So, early next year we'll be starting to build again.
So how many events have you been to this year? This is the last one, isn't it?
Yeah, so we're part of the circuit where there's 7 carnivals. So this is the last one tonight. So, yeah.
So when's the next one next year? Presumably the same tour as you're doing now.
Yeah, exactly the same. So we always start with Bridgwater Carnival, which is the first one of the circuit for us. Our home carnival based in Bridgwater. So yeah, that's always the first. And then we go on to Burnham. And then Burnham, I can't remember what we do anymore. It all changed. Burnham, we do North Petherton, Wales, Glastonbury, Shepton Mallet. Yeah, all that lot.
So obviously these carts take a lot of money to get them built. Where does all the money come from?
So we fundraise throughout the year. We do various different events. Each club will have their own events that they generally do. Some things will be regular bingos and community events. Other stuff will be bar hire and catering events. Glastonbury Festival's a big one. A lot of clubs get involved in that and raise money through the festival. Anything really that people can do to get some money to come in will go towards building the cart. So yeah, a lot of dedication throughout the year from all club members to get the funds in. Like you say, they do cost a few quid to make. So
when you're working through the year, you say about the different events that you do to raise money. Presumably it's a family thing, is it? You get the wives and girlfriends mucking in as well?
Yeah, I mean, particularly with Gremlins, it's pretty family orientated. There's a lot of family groups within it. So we've got a lot of young people coming up through now that have been born into the club. So they're now at an age where they're on the cart and performing and getting involved with the fundraising. So it does help when you've got a family unit doing it, because it's just nice, so you can do it all as a team. So yeah.
Presumably it's all your family members that are also helping with the creation of the costumes and the clothing?
Yeah, absolutely. We do use dressmakers, but other bits and pieces, all the extras that go on it. There's club members and and their families probably at home cutting bits out and sewing stuff on and putting embellishments on and tightening stuff up. So yeah, everyone mucks in.
I've got Spud here now. He's road crew captain.
The road crew for the clubs, they try and keep everybody safe on the cart and also people off of the cart. Obviously, for any incident that you may see in front of you happening before you get there, or keeping, in this case, we're a juvenile club, keeping the children safe on the cart as well to make sure there's no interaction from the crowd, which sometimes after they've had a couple of drinks, they want to get a bit too involved. So that's what we do, really. We just are there for the safety of our members and the crowd as well.
So which club is it that you belong to?
This is Hillview Carnival Club from Burnham-on-Sea. Yeah, we're the only club from Burnham-on-Sea now, and we are the only juvenile club here apart from Marina Sydenham from Bridgwater, and there is a club here from Weston. So any children out there who are interested in the Burnham-on-Sea area, give us a shout. Our base is at the Lighthouse Inn in Burnham-on-Sea, so give us a shout. Come and enjoy carnival with us.
So how long has your club existed for?
Oh, I'll ask if I get our chairperson in. He's not here. No, I know they've been going for many, many years now. Fritz? This is Fritz. This is the chairperson. He's been with the club many, many years. How many years, Fritz, has Hillview actually been on the road now, mate?
Hillview is 44, something like that. Yeah.
So,
and the club members who formed it, as in the families, are still involved now. The Nicholsons and the Berlins.
They're still going?
Yeah, they're still involved, and it's gone down three generations. It's good.
So what do you do as in the club?
Chairman, tractor driver, cart captain. Too many hats. Nah. No, so here tonight, it's just getting the kids around safely, getting the cart around safely.
So how many are there on the carts?
This cart is 17 kids, so.
This cart vary from 7 to 17, yeah, so.
Okay, thanks for your help, thanks a lot.
Thanks very much.
Hi there, we found another crew now, another cast members, and we got Gavin here.
Mm-hmm.
Which crew are you with, which club are you with?
So we're Masqueraders Carnival Club.
Ah, Masqueraders, you quite often do quite well with the judges, don't you?
We do tend to, yeah. We tend to be up in the tables generally most years, yeah.
Right, okay. And what's the theme this year?
Quite confusingly, this year we're doing Masquerade. So Masquerade by the Masqueraders.
Right, and how long have you been doing this for now?
Too many years, so probably about 15 years now I've been with Masqueraders. I was tableau before that, yeah.
Oh, wow.
And your friend over here, you're obviously going to be on there as well. What's your name?
Toby.
And how long have you been doing it for?
Just over 10 years now. Last 5 years with Masqueraders.
So what makes you do it?
Just the joy of doing it. I go down, help build it throughout the year, then we perform on it and then get drunk at the after parties.
So how long does it take to get the carts built through the year?
Literally all year. As soon as we're finished here, like before Christmas, we start like getting ideas for the next one, start taking it apart. And we'll be working throughout the whole year to get it ready.
So you'd be starting in the new year on it. Do you already know what you're going to be doing next year, or is that a top secret?
I mean, it would be top secret if we knew, but no. So January, we'll start the process of getting ideas together, and we'll have a series of meetings where everybody sort of brings the ideas to together, and we vote them down and come up with a collective idea that we want to move forward, and then we start some designs on it from that point.
Okay, thank you very much. Good luck this evening.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Here we are, there's another crew here. Your names are?
Naomi, Ashley,
Tom.
Tom, you're what's the theme this year? You're looking very piratey.
It's Escape the Locker, so it's Davy Jones and his pirate crew.
So which club do you belong to?
We're a dance troupe. It's called the Bridgwater Bells. Yep, Bridgewater Bells. That's all I can say about that.
So when you say dance troupe, that means you're one of the turns that aren't on a... Oh, there's a lorry coming. You're not actually on a cart then?
No, so we're like a walking entry. So we walk and dance, which is actually a lot harder than being on a cart. No, I'm joking. But yeah, it is good fun, very good fun.
How long have you been doing this for?
I've only been in the group for like 5 years, but you're the longest.
Yeah,
member.
So I've been in it for 10 years, but the group's been running for 30 years.
This year?
Yeah, this year, 30 years this year, yeah.
So it must be good fun doing it for 10 years.
Yeah, no, it is. Yeah, it's great, like social aspect and stuff as well. So definitely gets us out there.
Do you get involved through the year, presumably, with creating the costumes and everything?
Yeah, so we're obviously quite a small team. So we have like someone that's dedicated for costume. Obviously, we do makeup and we have help with makeup and hair and stuff as well. And yeah, it's just a massive team effort, really, for us.
So how many people are in the club?
At the moment, probably about 15, 16 of us, but there is only 7 dancers at the moment.
So it sounds as if you could do with a few more.
Yeah, no, definitely. I think as of sort of January next year, I know we've got a few more people sort of coming over to us. So hopefully our group will start to get bigger now. We're sort of getting noticed and stuff as well. So,
do you get many young people involved with it?
A lot of us are older. We've only got one little one and she's nine. She's nine. I think they used to have a lot of younger ones, but there isn't any more. There's just a lot more older ones. So, yeah.
Oh, well, thank you. Good luck this evening.
There are about 70 judges scattered around the route of the carnival. I've managed to waylay one of the judges who may be able to explain a bit more about it.
Morgan Carnival's in 1963.
Since 1963?
Yeah, I belong to a various club, but since 79 I joined Wick Carnival Club up to I retired in 2006, and then I've been judging on and off since then.
Quite a time. You go every year.
Yeah.
Apart from the last couple of years, obviously.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah.
There weren't many people about then.
So, tell me, what is it you're actually looking for?
Well, what they do is they split the classes into 5 categories, and each judge is given 2 categories of each class. Different judges judging different, like music and holes and things like that. So you only judge 2/5, so it cuts out the favouritism, hopefully, because most of the judges that are judging are ex-carnivalites anyway.
So, I mean, obviously the bigger clubs like Gremlins and Masqueraders, I suppose it's difficult not to place them up the top every time.
Well, if they're good enough, they'll be at the top.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
Right.
And the last one. This year, I think the standard is very good. There's not that difference now, because I think the top clubs have reached the peak, nearly, and the lesser clubs are touching them up. So the standard this year is very, very good, I think.
So I suppose there's been a bit of a problem over during COVID and such like.
Well, a lot of the clubs, you see, if they didn't keep up with their meetings, they lost members, and a lot of them didn't bother to come back. So that's why a lot of clubs are struggling for members. They found other things to do since COVID.
So,
but next year will be the telling point, not so much this year, because they've had 3 years to prepare for it. So it'll be interesting to see what next year's like.
So we're at the Glastonbury Carnival here. This is just the last of the big 7, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you judge on any of the others?
I judge at 4.
About four of them.
I could judge it all of them if I wanted, but I didn't want to.
So why is judging taking place for each one? Because the carts are exactly the same for each one, aren't
they? There's you've got different classes, and it's a competition. There's a overall winner at the end of it, and you've got your tableau carts, which is your standing still and still pose and everything, and then your feature carts. But everyone's in the same hat for the county champions. If you get the ones with the most points at the end of it, is county champions.
Right.
So it could be a feature, it could be a tableau.
So presumably they just get a cup.
Sorry?
My friends,
they have
Love Island in hell.
They have various, at the end of the carnivals, about, I think it's in December this year, it used to always be about 2 weeks after the last carnival, what we call the county presentation. And that's when the county championship is given out to all the various classes. You've not only got your two main feature and tableau, but you've got comic feature, you've got juvenile feature and tableau, and you've got your various walking groups. They all win county cups in there.
Okay. Hello, thanks for
thanks
a lot.
Cheerio.
I'm Thank you. Now have their score. Craig Greville Hall, Sir. Yeah.
come near. You draw a sack and eat me before you drink up all your beer. Father, Christmas isn't here. Let me sneak up and look down the rear. Everybody knows he's an 18 surprise and in disguise. The beer is false and nobody flies.
Yeah.